Mrs. Blandon, your husband died 20 years ago when his leaky oxygen cylinder blew up in the pub, triggering an explosion of the gas heating system.
They have a 40-year-old daughter together and she's still alive. And I'm sheltering the adulteress who gave birth to her. I'm living with the mother of my husband's illegitimate child and, if it wasn't for that very same floozy, Walter wouldn't have got all upset and punched my son Morris and he wouldn't have gone to Thailand and ended up in jail.
Think of what the consequences could have been for other people's sons if he'd got to Australia with his suitcase, he said. Some people don't care that they ruin other people's lives.
That was a blow. I had used those very words to accuse someone else of ruining Morris's life by planting drugs in his suitcase. I also understood then that the entire world, everyone on earth, knew truths that I had chosen not to believe.
Have you got a hanky? The constable said.
Of course I have, I said, reaching up into my sleeve. He ran his hand over his short hair. Whatever the problem was way back then, at this point we can't just leave her sitting on the street. She's frail and thin enough to blow away. There's no wind.
He had no comeback for that, by gum. So while he was regrouping, I complained about the helicopter.
The police helicopter woke me last night and it flies over at least 3 times a day. It's very, very loud, louder than the others.